Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new here, hi, I'm Angela. So today I'm going to be showing you guys my tanning routine and just like my tips and tricks on how to keep a flawless tan. So if you're interested, then just keep watching.
Okay guys, so the first thing you want to do is take a shower and you want to exfoliate and shave your entire body. I like to make sure that I shave the night before because if I do it the same day, I feel like when I put the tanning lotion on, it like seeps into those hair follicles that aren't fully closed yet. So make sure you do it the night before. And this is the exfoliator I use. I get it from Ulta. It's super duper nice and it smells so good. So my favorite tanning products to use are by Loving Tan, hands down. Like, they're so easy to use. The one that I'm using today is the one on the far right, which is the Deluxe Bronzing Mousse. I feel like mousses are so easy because they blend into the skin so well. I like to go use the darkest shade that they have, so I use dark. And I don't really have any specific way of applying the mousse. I just pump it out onto the mitt and then lather it onto my skin. And I have to work pretty quickly because this mousse does dry very fast. And as you can tell, I'm like really generous with the mousse. I go in like hard. Like you could see in the first clip, like I put on a lot just because I like to be dark. I'm very comfortable tanning myself. Like, I've been doing it for so long. But if you're not as comfortable, you can do like little by little because it's definitely buildable, which I love about this stuff. Like, even me like going in and doing it so aggressively, like I never get streaks. Also, I don't know if you guys are fans of the smell of self-tanner, but normally people aren't. It kind of has a funny smell. So this tanner that I'm using right now, the mousse, it actually has like a light floral scent. And I normally don't really like floral scents. I kind of try and stay away from that, but it smells really good. It's not overpowering and uncomfortable to smell. It actually smells really light and clean. So that is another plus. You guys are probably gonna notice that I haven't been like moving around the strings for my bikini because I really like the look of tan lines. So I'll kind of just like keep it in place and then work around it, if that makes sense, or on top. That's why this bikini is like completely stained and ruined. I would never wear this bikini out anywhere. And I did wanna mention really quick that this tanning mousse, once it's completely dry and developed, it is waterproof. So not water resistant, but it is waterproof. So you can submerge yourself in water and come out and it will not streak down your legs. This will only like be true if you do the initial rinse. You cannot like put it on and then the first water that you touch is the one at the beach, if that makes sense. Like, you have to take a shower, rinse off the excess, and then you're good to go. You'll still have tan underneath, just like the top extra will come off in the shower, which is normal. And then when you go to hang out with your friends at the beach, you'll have a nice little tan going. You'll dip yourself in the water, you know, go diving, you know, whatever you need to do, and then come back out and you'll still be tan. It won't be streaky down your legs. I promise you, I've done this multiple times. I'm so sorry for these clips right here, you guys. You literally can't see anything I'm doing, but I'm lathering up my legs. And usually for my legs, I have to do multiple pumps because there's a lot more surface area down there than there is on top. So at least for me, there is. So I have to like do a lot on my thighs, my calves. And then with your ankles, elbows, and places like that, you want to make sure you put on lotion prior. And just like a little bit of light lotion, nothing crazy. If you don't do it, it's fine. I've done it a lot of times. Have not used lotion and it's been fine, but it turns out nicer if you put a little bit of like hand cream on. That way it doesn't stick to those dry areas. So this is the part in the video where I love my tan so much that I'm just dancing in the mirror so confidently. Like, I love my tan. Clearly, this is why I'm dancing. But thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate you guys watching this video all the way through. Please make sure to thumbs it up and subscribe if you're not already, please, because it does help me out. And comment, leave me a comment. I read every single one as if there's a million.